Hello, Elsa. Did you look after George for me?
Hello,
hello,
darling.
Hello, George.
Good trip?
Not bad. A bit dusty. How's Elsa?
She missed her mum. I did my best as a babysitter, but I'm afraid I'm not the type. Do you know, she sat out here all night long waiting for you.
Poor thing. And poor you too, darling.
Come on, Elsa. I'll find something nice for you.
George seemed so much recovered from his attack of malaria that we left for Kyunga the very next day, wondering how Elsa would react to the sight of her first ocean. We reached Kyunga too late for anything except to make camp and then meet the local fishermen, who had come to tell George about their troubles with the lion who was decimating their goats. Under the circumstances, Elsa's presence seemed to puzzle them considerably. We were tired and had fallen asleep quickly. But I was awakened by noises coming from near the cars and the camp kitchen. There was no doubt that our cars, or our food, were providing a great temptation to someone. I didn't want to wake George. He'd looked so tired and pale when we arrived. I think it's John's goat eater.
Don't be silly. No lion would come into camp. It's probably a hyena or a leopard or something.
No, it's a lion. I saw it. I was out there by the cook tent.
Oh. What were you doing? Oh, all right. Go back to bed.
Thank you.
Did you see him?
Yes, I saw him. Go to sleep.
What happened?
I'd rather not discuss it. Go to sleep.
What are you doing?
Getting a drink of water. Look, will you or will you not go to sleep? That. Work finished ahead of schedule. From tomorrow, we play. Marvelous watchdog you are.
After our first walk along the beach, we all trooped down to the water's edge to introduce Elsa to the Indian Ocean. At first, she was put off by the growl and rush of the waves and the taste of the water, and perhaps by the audience we had collected, and which was looking on from a safe distance. But soon her characteristic curiosity prevailed, and she enjoyed herself tremendously. Thank you.